This video explains how to use CRP5 to calculate true altitude, and we are starting right now. Hello and welcome to Answering ATPL. The focus of this channel is to provide solutions for EASA ATPL questions and other aviation related stuff. Let me know in the comment section below if you are currently taking ATPL theoretical examination. This video is the 10th video of a series of videos explaining the usage of CRP5 computer face. If this is your first time here, consider subscribing to my channel, and click on the bell icon to get notified when I publish a new video. Before we look into the procedure of using CRP5 to calculate true altitude, we will first look at altitude terminology that will be used throughout this video. Height is indicated on the altimeter when its subscale is set to QFE. Height is defined as the vertical distance above a selected ground level datum, usually your home airfield. With QFE as set, the altimeter will read zero when the aircraft is on the ground. Altitude, or sometimes referred as indicated altitude, is indicated on the altimeter when its subscale is set to QNH. Altitude is defined as the vertical distance above mean sea level. Pressure altitude is indicated on the altimeter when its subscale is set to standard pressure setting of 1013.2 millibars. Pressure altitude is the vertical distance above the standard pressure datum. Sometimes the standard pressure datum is referred to as 1013.2 hectopascals. Pressure altitude is typically expressed as flight level, which is pressure altitude divided by 100. For instance, 15,000 feet equals flight level 150. The altimeter is calibrated to ICAO standard atmosphere ISA conditions. Variation of temperature from ISA value cause inaccuracies on the altimeter. For a detailed explanation of true altitude, check out my other video explaining this subject. To go to this video, you can click on the I icon on the top right corner of the screen after watching this video, or you can find the link in the description section below. To calculate true altitude using CRP5, we need pressure altitude, indicated altitude, and outside air temperature. To find the true altitude using CRP5. First, align pressure altitude with outside air temperature in the altitude window. Next, rotate the cursor so that it is aligned with the indicated altitude on the inner scale. Then, read off the true altitude on the outer scale. An example will make the procedure clear. If the indicated altitude obtained with QNH set is 9,300 feet, and the pressure altitude obtained with 1013.2 millibar set is 10,000 feet with the outside air temperature of minus 20 degrees Celsius, what is the true altitude? First, align the pressure altitude, 10,000 feet, with outside air temperature, minus 20 degrees Celsius, in the altitude window. I will first move the cursor so that we can see the operation clearer. Next, align the cursor with the indicated altitude, 9,300 feet, on the inner scale. Against the indicated altitude on the inner scale, read off the true altitude, on the inner scale. 8,730 feet. That will be all for this video. If you feel that this video is beneficial for you, please like the video. In doing so, you are helping others to find the video. And, don't forget to subscribe and leave some comment. In the next video in this video series, we will discuss on density altitude. If you want to learn more about ATPL or aviation, start now by hitting the round subscribe icons. Also, if you have any questions or comments about ATPL or aviation related problems, you can leave them in the comments section. Thank you so much for watching, I'll see you next time.